Have you ever wanted a strategy that can help you get the that one commando skin? I don't know its name. Which, and you're certainly in this part of the quest, which I was originally. Well, this strategy has got your back.
I must say, I'm unimpressed.
There are gonna be a few times when the military base glitches and doesn't end up spawning anything in. That's when you want to restart. And it's pretty crucial to follow some of the steps. This video will be released an hour before the Molten update. And also, matchmaking sucks. Like, a lot. I somehow got paired with a level 0. And yet, I'm like level... almost like level 490.
I must say, I'm unimpressed!
Follow this strategy very precisely. For wise, it could cost you a lot of time. Yes, this does take a lot of time if you don't have a time scale ticket. For the sake of better understanding of what you're supposed to do. And to make the strategy easier on yourself, I'm not gonna speed it up. Also, don't use power-ups in this one. I'm pretty sure you can use any DPS tower, but I recommend Pursuit, because then you could just use the ability to move it from place to place. And the airstrike, in the strategy, it says that airstrike is recommended for waves 33 and onward for the Fallen Jesters and the Fallen Giants. Also, don't skip any of the waves. The wave bonus is actually going to help you a lot. Especially on the later one, on the later waves when it's 1,000. I don't know why these military bases are so small in this, just specifically for this game. But thank you. Yeah, hey, actually made Trapper actually pretty good now. Oh my. Let's just turn small so I don't take up most of your screen. So I just placed all my commandos over here the last time I won, so that the missiles can like cover over here and over here. I don't know how big the missile range is, but we'll have to see. This video is gonna be super long because it took me almost 40 minutes to complete the last one. Not the last video, but the last match. Big updates in the span of 5 days from the Molten rework on this Wednesday to Operation Ice in nearly a week from now. Nearly. I said nearly because it's a week and a day. Week and 1 day. Finally get support lore. Yeah, I've honestly no idea what the heck they would come up with for the as an event tower for the event. Also, I'm hoping they bring a skin creep back. Not the holiday skins, but the Christmas skins, which I know some people are getting upset about. But I just kind of want every skin. And I hope they don't do that. Over-exaggerated battle pass. Makes sense why this guy's aggro, because you kind of want to get the biggest of the bunch. After this, I'll have to do Space City. Okay, yeah, maybe I'm making a mistake by skipping the wave. And not waiting for the wave bonus. The wave bonuses are really helpful. Spawn, please. Oh my. might lose, actually. At least we're no longer verge of death. How annoying aggro is, like. Actually, it's not that bad once you have some actual good counters or have decent DPS, but I've been getting it. Oh my. Yeah, I don't care. If it's to save my run. don't skip any of these waves. Otherwise, here we go. Basically, overcrowded. You could place these rangers wherever you wish, but this is just where I would. This is just where I would place them. Now, all the rest of this is just maxing out your towers, along with using the abilities of the towers. Especially if you're gonna use the pursuit, and if you're using the, well, not if, but, you know, you're using them to your base. And yes, it does tell you to max, that strategy does tell you to max your military bases first. Remember to start using the airstrike ability on all fallen giants and all fallen jesters, especially the jesters on wave 39. I didn't even see that jester there. Now, this is the part where you want to start spamming and maxing your DPS. Usually, the strategy says for you to put your DPS along right here. Like, along basically along these two sides of the building. And I'm just getting path A pursuits for the DPS. Now, wave 39 is the way you're going to want to specifically get ready for. Just, like, guard the entrance with your... Guard the entrance of the map with your ability. Yeah, this is a bit less. The end game, so I'm gonna be speaking a lot more now than I. Well, not really speaking a lot more, though, so. Traps are actually really useful against these dang guards. It's gonna be okay if you have only the two jesters left, your trappers can deal for this. You know, this is the part where your commando comes in, where the commando part of the quest. Don't worry, you'll be able to max out all of your commandos. I actually find it a bit sad they got rid of the Fallen King stomp, but also a bit messy. Because then, well, these things would run past all of our defenses. Also, I just recommend to start using all the missiles when you have all the commandos maxed. So that way you have a buttload of DPS. Just as long as you micro your towers, like just as long as you micro your DPS, keep using any abilities that will benefit you, then you should be good. Guys, I got 8,000 HP shield going. Down with the king. And that's it. You've done it. And there's no way you should be trying to trigger a hit like this. That's the strategy that helped me to get commando. Anyways, I'll release a video when I see a good Cyber City strategy. And that's all for today. See you guys later. Bye.